In the previous video, we started talking about composition. Let's continue on now and look at another scenario whereby we can actually hide the functionality further so that we don't allow the calling program to access those objects directly. So let's go and have a look at the example. So what we'll do first is we're going to go to our PC class. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to change these and make these private. So in other words, the functions, these getters, won't be accessible by our main class anymore. And just to go back and show you what happened, we're now getting an error. And it's saying it's got private access. So in other words, they won't be able to access them any further. But we'll still be able to access those internally. So let's create a function, public void power up. And I'm going to use get case, or get the case, dot press power button. Then I'm going to type draw logo. So if you think about it, a computer, when it starts up, you press the power button, and then you see a logo come up on the screen, which is usually the logo of the motherboard manufacturer. So we're going to implement that little private method. And it might do some fancy, you know, graphics here. I'm not going to obviously write that code yet, but it'll be doing that there. And let's just say it called this method. So we can either use the get monitor dot draw pixel at, you know, 1250 yellow, whatever we wanted to do, using the getter, or we could access it directly by accessing the variable group directly. It really depends the way you're setting yourself up. Probably the better way of doing it would be the way that I'm showing you there with the monitor on the screen, because we don't really need those getters. They're not actually adding anything to us. They're really just making the code a little bit more complex than what we need. If we needed to do something else, in other words, if we needed to check whether the case had been, if we needed to check whether the objects had been initialized, we're looking for something else, some other sort of form of validation and verification, we might want to leave those getters in there. But what we could actually do is actually get rid of those altogether to make our code look a bit more streamlined, and then just change it and just access those variables directly. Of course, that's the case. So we've now got a public function called PowerUp and a private function called draw logo, and of course the power up function of the PC will draw that logo on the screen, as I mentioned before. We go back to our main class. Obviously these methods won't work anymore because now we've actually deleted them. So I'm going to delete those. But what we could do is put the PC dot power up. If we run that, you can see that the power button was pressed, drawing pixels at 1250 in color yellow. So obviously to access that, we accessed the pc.powerup method. So I went to our PC powerup method, which called the case.pressPowerButton, which then references the case object that's been created for this class. And if you have a look at our case code, it's calling the press power button method to show that message on the screen. Then of course, the second thing it did was it actually drew the logo. And it used the monitor.drawPixelAt method. And of course, the monitor method does the system output there. So that, in essence, is what composition is. It's actually creating objects within objects. So you're having like a master object. In this case, the PC is managing and looking after. And this is using composition to achieve that, as opposed to inheritance that we looked at in the previous video. So in a future video, what I'm going to do is explain where you should be using inheritance and where you should be using composition. As a general rule, when you're designing your programs in Java, you probably want to look at composition first. So if you do any sort of research on the internet, most of the experts will tell you that as a rule, to look at using composition before inheritance, and it does give you added advantages and more flexibility. But with that said, it does depend on the solution, what you're trying to achieve. Okay, so it's challenge time. So the challenge is to create a single room of a house using composition. So think about the things that should be included in this room. Maybe some physical parts of the house, maybe some physical parts of the room, but also furniture as well if you like, anything you think should be included in the room. You can create as many objects as you want to compose this out into whatever level of detail you want to get into. But make sure you add at least one method to access an object that is composed, which is part of that main class, to be accessing that via a getter, and then to then access via a public method that object that was returned from the getter. And you saw me do that in the previous video. And also then add at least one method to hide the object completely, in other words, not using the getter, basically access that object from another public class. And you saw me do that in this video. So go ahead and do that and see what you can come back with. And when you're ready, come back and check out my solution. So pause the video now and I'll see you back shortly. Okay, hopefully you managed to figure it out and you had some fun along the way. Let's go ahead and now implement one possible scenario. So what I'm going to do is implement a bedroom. So I'm going to create first the main class and call it bedroom. And I'm going to have a bedroom and it's going to be first have a name. Even though we know it's a bedroom, I'm just going to have a name anyway, not Tim's, you know, bedroom or something like that. And I'm going to create an object called wall. I'm going to have wall 1 through 4. Because obviously there's 4 walls. I'm going to have a ceiling. I'm going to have a bed because it's a bedroom. And just for an accessory, let's go for the lamp. So I'm now going to create a constructor, which is going to be everything and quite a few things there. And just to keep things simple, I'm going to create a getter for lamp. I'll just create it manually. And let's create a public method for making the bed. And we're going to put some a note there to indicate what we're doing. We're in the bedroom class, making bed. And then we're going to do bed.make. Okay, so I'm just going to breeze through these other classes because they're going to be pretty basic. Let's create the wall class first. I'm going to call it wall. And we're just going to have one string, one field. We'll call it direction, where it's facing. And let's just create a constructor. And let's create a getter. Very simple wall. And for ceiling, let's do something similar. So we're going to do create ceiling, glass ceiling. And this one I'm going to have a height where the ceiling starts. And let's just go with, say, painted color. What the current color of the ceiling is, constructor, and we're also the getters as well. And you can see now as I'm creating that, some of these errors are going away because I'm creating the classes. Next, I'm going to create the bed class. So with the bed, let's start with the style. Let's style a bed. How many pillows, what the height is of the bed from the ground, maybe the number of sheets, and whether it has a quilt or how many quilts. Create a constructor. Then we'll create our getters. But then we also need to create our make method, because if you recall, we're using bed.make over here. So let's create that as well, and we'll call that it's a void method, and we'll call it make. And we'll just have a simple message that outputs, this time we're in the bed class, making. Okay, so we now created that as well, and our bedroom class is looking good now. We've just got the lamp to implement now. So I'm going to create that now. Lamp. And let's try private string style, private Boolean battery. Is it a battery powered lamp? Yes or no? And globe rating, perhaps. Create the constructor. And let's create the getters. And let's create a method here to turn on the lamp. So public void turn on. Turning on. So we should now have got rid of all those errors. So we've now got a valid class there, which is good. So let's go back to our main method now and implement this. So what I'm going to do is start by creating our walls. I'm going to put wall one equals new wall, start west, create four walls. South and then north. Make them all unique. We need a ceiling. And if you recall, we'll say it's say a 12-foot ceiling, painted color, just an integer, 55. We need to create a bed. We've got bed equals new bed. Modern, four pillows, 3 foot perhaps, two sheets, one quilt. So there's our bed. And lastly, we need to create a lamp. So lamp equals new lamp. We'll say it's classic, false, no battery. And we'll say it's 75 is the globe rating. So we've now got the base objects that we can now pass to our bedroom to create this new bedroom. So to do that, we can do bedroom equals new bedroom. And of course, the parameters it needs is the bedroom name. We'll call it Tim's room. Or just Tim's will be enough because we know it's Tim's bedroom. And wall one, wall two, wall three, wall four, ceiling, bed, and of course, lamp. So we've now got our valid object bedroom created. So how do we make the bed? Well, if you recall from our bedroom object, we created a method called makeBed, which then itself called the method bed from the bed object. So all we have to do there is put bedroom.makeBed. That's how we make the bed. And the other way of accessing it, which was via the getter, bedroom.getLamp. Dot turn on. Let's try running that. So you can see the bedroom class was called first, making the bed, which it and then in turn called the method make from the bed object that's part and parcel of this class. And then of course the other way of accessing it, which is via the getter, use that to access the lamp object, which again is part of our bedroom object, and turned on the light. So you can see that composition is very, very powerful. And as we progress through this course, you'll see examples of composition. And as I mentioned earlier, you'll understand more where to use inheritance and where to use composition. But as a general rule, you would aim for composition. That's what generally a lot of object-oriented programming experts suggest you do, is at least look at that first. So hopefully you did well in your challenge. In the next video, we're going to talk about encapsulation, which is another component of object-oriented programming. And it's something that you've actually been using for some time now, but probably weren't aware that you were using it. So I'm going to explain that in more detail in the next video.